Hello, this is Archisha from Kenchi School, and today I'll be showing two projects using Tubby Craft supplies. The first project is this cute Christmas card, which has a very vintagey look. For this, I'm using the Tubby Craft Shine On Clear stamp set, and first I'll color this out using my alcohol markers. For the card, I wanted to create a Christmas Eve kind of scene, and for this I wanted an ideal wallpaper look because it's from the vintage time, and I think the Tubby Craft number 11 stencil, which has these bars and stars, was totally perfect for this. I'm going to blend some chocolate brown Tubby Craft dye ink on this craft cardstock. It has some basic stitching details on its edges. And I'm just using this makeup brush, which I got from Amazon, to blend out the chocolate brown ink. And when I pull my cardstock out, you can see that it gives me a crisp image. For the floor, I'm using this pattern paper, which I have also die cut with the stitch details. I'm going to create a window in the in my vintage scene. It is going to be basically a snowy wintry night outside. For this, I've cut out a yellow frame, a snowfall die cut, and a white paper at the background to give the snow look. Here I'm just cutting off the extra from the edges. For my window panel, I'm going to distress it as well using the chocolate brown ink and my makeup brush to complete that vintage look. I'm sticking my window frame onto my night sky using some foam tape for more dimension. I have also die cut this oval piece of patterned paper for a rug, which usually goes under the Christmas tree. Next, like the window frame, I'm going to distress the edges of my rug as well as the floor. To complete the distressed look, I'm adding some distressing using the same chocolate brown dye ink by Tubby Craft onto my card panel, only on the edges. Here I'm sticking my floor, that is actually the carpet, not the floor, using some liquid glue. Next, I will stick the rug. On top of the rug, I'll stick my Christmas tree using some foam adhesives. Next to the tree goes my little cute girl with the star in her hand. It seems like she's trying to reach at the top of the tree to put up that star. Now I'm going to start working on the accessories. So for starters, I have this little glass jar next to the tree which has few shiny things. On top of the tree, there's going to be a string which is going to have the holy leaves of Christmas. These accessories are also stamped from the same stamp set, that is the Tubby Craft Shine On Clear stamp set. Now I'm sticking the entire assembly of the snowy window with some liquid glue onto my card panel. And on the string, I'm going to add some holly leaves, and I've got some dimensional adhesives behind those. These are from the same stamp set. I'm using the sentiment "Wishing you a shining Christmas," and I'm inking it up with Tubby Craft Sapphire Blue ink. Here I have a nice light blue cardstock on which I will be stamping my sentiment. Next, I will cut it into a strip and give it a fishtail edge on one side, and then put some foam adhesives behind it, and I'm going to tuck it behind the Christmas tree and place it right below that snowy window. Now this entire panel will directly go on my card base, and we are almost done with assembling this card. Finally, for more texture, I am adding some crystal drops, which usually dry out to be like clear pearls, to give more dimension to my card. And that finishes the first project for today, which is a vintage Christmas card. As you can see in the images over here, the Tubby Craft stencil is the most perfect background for this card. For my next project, I'll be creating these two vintage Christmas tags. And for these tags, I'll be using the Tubby Craft Christmas Wishes Clear stamp set. For the first tag, I'll be using Tubby Craft Lawn Green Dye ink, and I'm using the Tubby Craft number 13 stencil, which is like a checkerboard. Using the makeup brush, I'll spread out my ink on the entire panel. Next, I'm taking some Tubby Craft Emerald Green Dye ink, but I'll make sure to smoosh my ink only on the edges of the tag. When I pull off my stencil, you can see that gradient and this lovely crisp finish of the stencil. For the second tag, I'm using Tubby Craft number 14 stencil, which is like these random, very whimsical polka dots, and I'm using the Tubby Craft Aqua Blue dye ink on the entire panel. Just like my green tag, I'll be using a darker color here as well. I'm using the Tubby Craft Sapphire Blue dye ink only on the edges to give more depth in my tags. And the moment of peel off is here, and I love this design. It looks super, super cool. From the Christmas Wishes stamp set, I'm using this gift stamp and some Imperial Red Tubby Craft dye ink. I'll be stamping my gift box image randomly on the entire panel of both the tags. I'm using the Tubby Craft small acrylic block for stamping my images, and I love these acrylic blocks and how comfortable it is to use them. I'm stamping the big sentiment from the stamp set using some Tubby Craft jet black dye ink. I have stamped it on this craft scallop die cut, and to give it a little more vintagey look, I'm again using the Tubby Craft chocolate brown dye ink only on the edges using my makeup brush. And I absolutely loved the outcome. It actually looks like an old paper cutting. And now the tags actually don't look that vintagey, so I went in with chocolate brown dye ink on the edges, as well as the Tubby Craft mustard yellow dye ink. This also gives that old paper kind of look because her tags are really white, and I think they look super, super, super cute with that craft panel in the middle. You know, I love giving dimension to all my projects, so I'm gonna stick that craft panel also using some foam adhesives. Now first I thought I'll be sticking them straight, but I think these crooked panels look a little different and more homely rather than being more made in the current ages. We wanted to give that old look, right? So I gave that old crooked panel kind of look. Now I'm adding some strings. I've added a red and white as well as blue and white twine. I'll be adding the same twine combination on both my tags. And finally, to complete the look, I'm tying this green satin ribbon, which is like a grassy green color. I'm also going to fishtail the edges of my satin ribbon, and then to render it from peeling any further, I'm going to use a lighter and seal the edges of the ribbon so that, you know, a strand doesn't keep coming and then you lose out on the entire ribbon. Does that happen to you? Happens to me all the time. Here is a closer look of how it seals the ribbon. You don't really have to get it too close, and please don't try this alone if you're not used to using a lighter. And it's pretty easy, but children trying this out, please don't do this on your own. Now adding the extra embellishments. I'm adding some red berry nougat crystals. I wanted to mimic those berries you see on the holy leaves. So this adds a little pop of color as well, and a little more dimension and more glossy texture here and there on your tag. Finally, a splatter or a drizzle of white diluted paint to give all that snowy effect of our wintry Christmas. And that is the completed tag. You see how very vintagey it looks, and it was so easy. We just had to distress the edges. I hope you like both the vintage projects for today, and please do try out the new Tubby Craft stencils. Bye!